huge change of course for a city known for its strict gun laws. About an hour ago, the D.C. City Council voted to allow licensed gun owners to apply for a concealed carry permit. News 4's Mark Seagrave live outside the Wilson Building now with more on the implications of this vote today. Mark?
That's right, Jim, and the reason we're here today is because a federal judge weeks ago struck down the district's ban on carry permits, saying it was unconstitutional. And then today we learned that U.S. Attorney's Office is no longer prosecuting handgun carry violations until this is all resolved. So the council knew they had to do something. This is not what they wanted to do. The D.C. Council reluctantly voted to allow for residents and non-residents to apply for concealed carry permits.
This is always a difficult situation for the District of Columbia when we are put here. We'd like to have much stricter no carry rules at all, and preferably no guns at all, but the courts are ruling against us on this on a regular basis, and if they're not, then the Congress is coming down on us.
While the council unanimously approved allowing for carry permits, one issue facing lawmakers that wasn't resolved today is the question whether the names of those who are issued a concealed carry permit should be made public. On that issue, the council members are divided.
We should at least give our neighbors and the residents a chance to know who has the gun. Put it up there. Let people, you know, be proud of it if they want to carry a concealed weapon, but at least we'll all know who it is and we can treat them differently because they have a deadly threat in their possession.
I'm uneasy about that. It runs the risk that we're providing a means for somebody to find out who has a gun that then burglarize or rob.
Who cares about the confidentiality of a gun owner? We don't want it.
While the issue of gun owners' privacy remains up in the air, one thing is clear. Gun rights advocates still aren't satisfied, saying the new law is still too restrictive. We don't live in a country where rights are enjoyed only at the police's pleasure. The court instructed the city to treat the carrying of handguns for self-defense as a right the city should comply with, not resist the court's decision, wrote Alan Gura, a lawyer for the plaintiffs, who tells News 4 he plans to go back to court and challenge this new law. Now, important to note, this new law, when it takes effect, will not allow for open carry. And as we said, the D.C. government is still keeping open its option to appeal the original ruling that struck down the entire ban. And Alan Gura, for the plaintiffs, that attorney, he does plan to appeal this new law and challenge it in court. And of course, you won't be able to register right away, but when you can, applications will be open to both D.C. residents and non-residents alike. Reporting live from the Wilson Building, Mark Seagraves, News 4. Thank you.